into fractional laws of indices, and we look at the negative laws as well. So fractional laws of indices means the power, the index will be in fraction form. So for example, if I write a to the power of a half, okay, please don't make the mistake of halving the number. This means the square root, okay? So that is the same as the square root. So find the square root of the number, okay? So for example, if I say 16 to the power of a half, please, this is not the same as 16 times half, which gives you 8, or it doesn't mean half 16. The half means the square root of 16. So you do your square root of 16. Square root of 16 means go on your times table, find a number that when you times by the same number gives you 16. So that means 4 times 4 is 16. So the square root of 16 is 4. Okay. Then again, we could have any number to the power of 1/3. This is the cube root of the number. Cube root. Okay. So for example, let's look at 8 to the power of 1/3. It means go on your times table, find any number that when you multiply by the number and multiply it again by the same number, it gives you 8. So if you look at the 2 times table, 2 times 2 is 4, 4 times 2 is 8. So let's look at this. 2 times 2 times 2. 2 times 2 is 4, 4 times 2 equals 8. So in this case, the cube root of 8 equals 2. So when you see this, they are all fractional laws of indices. But let's look at this type. If I have a to the power of 2 over 3, okay, then what this means in the law of indices is that the denominator, the down number, tells you what root you have to take. So a square, cube root, fourth root, fifth root. So because this is 3, it means we need to take the cube root of a, the number. Then the numerator tells you what to do after your answer. So in this case, it means square it. So let's look at an example here. Let's say 27 to the power of 2 over 3. Okay. What this means is that we need to take the cube root of 27 and then square our answer. That's what this means. So in this case, find a number that when you times by itself 3 times gives you 27. So if you look on your 3 times table, 3 times 3 is 9. 9 times 3 is 27. So it means the cube root of 27 is 3. Okay? Then the numerator says square. So I need to square the 3. So 3 squared is the same as 3 times 3. So in this case, the answer would be 9. So the answer to this type of question is 9. Okay? So it's not anything strange. Let's look at a different question. Let's say we have 81 to the power of 3 over 4. Okay? In this case, the denominator, the down number, is 4. So it means do the fourth root of 81. The fourth root of 81. That's the down number. Then the answer you get, the numerator says cubed it. So you're going to do it 3 times. So in this case, again, you go in your times table. I'll know that 3 times 3 is 9 times 3. 27. 27 times 3 is 81. Okay, if you do it this way. If you don't know, just use numbers on your times table. Try and error and you'll get it. This gives me 81. So it means the fourth root of 81 is 3. That's the down number down. The top number, the numerator says I should cube it. So that is the same as 3 times 3 times 3, which means the answer is 27. So that is the fractional law. Denominator tells you what root to take. Numerator tells you what to do after you've taken the root. Now let's look at the negative ones. Again, I'm going to use similar examples. Let's say we have 27 to the power of minus 2 over 3. Okay, this is not anything difficult. You do the same process as this. By your final answer, you put it as 1 over. The final answer, you put it as 1 over, because one of the laws of indices states that if I have a, okay, any number to the power of minus m, then the law says we can write that as 1 over a to the power of m. Okay, so in this case, this can be written as 1 over 27 to the power of positive 2 over 3. What it means is just do the same working out here, but remember your answer has to be 1 over whatever you get. So we've done the root of 27 here. So again, you do the cube root of 27 and then square it. Cube root of 27 is 3. So I'm making this way. Top number says square it. Okay. And then 3 squared equals 9. But because it was to the power of negative, all I have to do is write my answer as 1 over 9. That's all you do. We'll just write it as 1 over 9. So whenever it's negative, I'm not going to do a lot of examples. Whenever it's negative, all you have to do is your final answer, you put 1 on top of it. So your numerator will be 1 over the number. So for example, if I choose to do, let's say, 16 to the power of minus half. Okay, then all I'm saying is that I need to take the square root of 16 to the power of minus 1. Square root of 16 is 4. Okay, but the power of minus 1 just makes it 1 over 4. Okay, so whenever there is a minus, because if any number to the power of 1 is the same number, that is why the 4 didn't change. So when it's negative, please do this same method. Get your answer, just put 1 over that. And that is the easiest way to remember. So nothing changes. It's the same method, the same process. And I'm sure this should help you to do it. Remember this. This always comes in foundation exams and people get it wrong. Any number to the power of half does not mean times by half. It means the square root. Any number to the power of 0 equals 1. And this is what we mean by the fractional laws of indices and the negative fraction law or the negative power law. If we run example of this, so for example, if I write 2 to the power of minus 1, it just means half. Okay, so that's the negative. It just means put 1 over the number, and that should be your answer. So hopefully this will help you whenever you see the laws of indices. It doesn't matter how the question is done, take your time, understand the question, do the step one by one, remember the laws, and it should make it easy and simple for you. So that brings us to the end of our laws of indices. We've treated the easy ones. Now this was the fraction and the negative power laws. I hope you enjoyed this, and remember you can leave your comment at any time. Thank you.